Everything that you are going to see inside this presentation has been made with zero density render engine. Why use augmented reality for live sports production? So here we are talking about organizers of multiple events, but so mainly virtual advertising, of course, it's a big stuff. Marketing, of course, because you are able, you know, to show more dynamic about brands. And of course, you will see a lot of examples of venue enhancement and data visualization. Of course, we are going to talk a little bit about storytelling, you know, content enrichment, gamification. You will see a couple of them. We can go through this small slide. Some virtual advertising, by example, we started in stadium 3 years ago by adding for hockey, for football. And during COVID, you remember the stands were empty. And at that time, what was interesting was to put 3D crowd or virtual stands inside existing environment. And so even the UEFA told me, yeah, it was the best 3D integration, you know, inside real stadium. So virtual fans, of course, you can take the control on it, or a giant, you know, application for marketing and interactive fans engagement, fireworks, it is of course cost effective, gamification, and perhaps you know the virtual lion at Africa Cup of Nations in Africa Cup in Cameroon in 2022. Okay, but since last year we produce augmented reality on drones, and now it's a work in progress. We are trying to get some results on the helicopter. Everything, of course, that you are going to see here is made live, okay, real time and live. This is our famous virtual paint that you can put on everything, and so yeah, different examples on how to use the augmented reality for sports production. Okay, so we can just have a look. This is a small video. It's a 1 minute video with some of the examples. So with the drones and for cycling, mostly because you know that for the cycling, they have to paint all the roads everywhere, every time. So here we propose a solution which is better for environment and is also cost savings, you know. Virtual lion in Cameroon, or what we are going to see a little bit more in details, it's Spa Francorchamps with a circuit. Now we have a partnership in order to propose, you know, that kind of innovation and that kind of uses for motorsport. What are the content of a partnership with Spa-Francorchamps? I would like to tell you what are the feelings of the CEO of the circuit. He say for him it's significant savings in transport, production and painting, you know, because they are using liters and liters of paint in the grass, and after, when you know it's too dry, the grass is not growing, and so they cannot cut off and can get off the sponsor. And of course, from his point of view, it's multiply the appearances of sponsor without producing great advertisements, which are normally standard. So environmental impact, this is very important for them, by eliminating, of course, track paint or grass paint. And of course, presentation, more dynamic presentation of race information and that kind of thing. Of course, gamification and virtual fan engagement and fans engagement are also a big point of interest. Okay, we can show also some the customer, so the organizer of the race is what he said. He said that it's the use of AR open new perspectives, you know, and greater creativity for sponsors. Of course, everybody knows about virtual advertising, but what we are proposing, as you have seen, it's a more wider environment and more dynamic, of course. And what was new during the 24 hours of Spa-Francorchamps, it was that we enlightened the augmented reality during, especially during night, or we adapt it also at a weather condition. So it was really, really new stuff. And so I hope that next year we will do a lot of motorsport races. And from my point of view, you know that perfection does not exist. And so what made the credibility of our augmented reality elements and insertion, it's because we are working on these imperfections, you know? We know that perfection doesn't exist. So by example, I will show you in a few moments in the video. By example, we are adding virtual trees, virtual bushes, different things in order to create more credibility. So by example, here, this is virtual, of course. The first one, Fanatec, is virtual. These one are virtual. This one on the walls, on the grass as well, virtual screen, banner, and the arch here is virtual as well. So it can help, you know, to enhance when you in some view angles. Sometimes it's really, you know, poor, but here, thanks to the technology and the way we are using, of course, the CrowdStrike there is virtual also. You can notice there is a small zeppelin here, and you see that during night you are still able, you know, to see here the different augmented reality elements, which we have enlightened, or the arch. And so, of course, during a 24 hours race, it's very important, because otherwise you cannot propose to your customer. The Fanatec I like is one of my favorite. The work that we do, and of course we have to do it, it's not AI, you know, it's HI, it's human intelligence. So sometimes you need still some human intelligence, yeah. So during, by example, by rain, by different things, so we always adapt in order to create the best. This one is my favorite, you know, the first one here, if this is virtual. And so we put some small lights in order to enlighten, to do like in real life. So integrations, you can see, you notice the way we were using the augmented reality elements. When I told you about imperfection and details, you know, here this is a virtual arch, but we put a small bush here. Yeah, this is virtual as well, just because it's more credible if you had some that kind of element. That's the only thing. So you can see it there. You see here the clean footage, and you see also the final result. Of course, everything is live. You see the real Fanatec board. You see the augmented one. So this is what we call adaptive augmented reality. And actually, only humans can do it. So it's our added value. Yes. And of course, different uses of paint on the track with data, or in the walls, you can probably see the difference, of course. When I was talking about fan engagement, this is the kind of thing you are able to do to try to get a feed from your community and to be able to interact with them during the event. This is also virtual advertising. It was really tough because here it was a really big box lens. So it was difficult to calibrate. Something which is interesting is the live augmented reality on drones. And for this, we are using Quidditch, which is an Indian company, which is a partner. And so we are able, you know, to track the aerial shot. And then it's linked to zero density in order for us to add the augmented reality elements. Dynamic virtual advertising, virtual arch, everything you can do. This is only, of course, some of the ideas, but I'm sure that you will get more and more, and in the next future, for sure, it will be implemented in each sport event. Thank you.